Ever wondered how those massive metal birds soar effortlessly through the sky? Today, we are unlocking the secrets of flight by diving into the fascinating world of lift. I'm thrilled to take you on a journey where we demystify the magic that propels aircraft into the clouds. Get ready for a captivating exploration of the forces, shapes, and physics behind one of humanity's most incredible achievements, flight. To truly appreciate the enchantment of flight, we must comprehend lift, the force that allows aircraft to ascend. Lift, in simple terms, is the upward force produced by wings interacting with the surrounding air, defying gravity. Now let's delve into the intricate details of lift production, how the airfoil shape actively contributes to lift and interacts with the airflow, the fundamental physics concepts and principles that illuminate the mechanics behind lift generation, and specifically, we'll discuss two prominent theories, Newton's third law and Bernoulli's principle. These theories provide valuable insight into the forces at play, shedding light on the captivating science behind the phenomenon of flight. To uncover the mysteries of flight, let's explore the airfoil, the unsung hero of lift generation. But what exactly is an airfoil? An airfoil is a unique teardrop shape that produces low drag. For insights into how an airfoil contributes to reduced drag, be sure to visit the video link on drag provided in the description below. This airfoil shape is used to construct nearly all parts of the aircraft, including the wings, fuselage, propeller, struts, etc. You can see the airfoil shape when you view the cross section of a wing. Now let's break down the key components that make up an airfoil, starting with the upper camber and lower camber. Camber simply means arc or curve. The upper camber refers to the curvature of the top surface of the wing, while the lower camber is the curvature of the bottom surface. Together, they contribute to the overall shape that allows air to flow smoothly over and under the wing. Moving along our airfoil journey, we encounter the leading edge and the trailing edge. These are the front and back edges of the wing, respectively. The leading edge is the forward-facing edge that meets the oncoming air, initiating the airflow over the wing. On the other hand, the trailing edge marks the end of the wing, where the airstream leaves the wing. Now let's connect the leading edge and the trailing edge with an imaginary line. This imaginary line that runs from the leading edge to the trailing edge of the airfoil is the chord line. The chord line provides us with a reference for measuring the wing's dimensions and angles, offering a standardized way to discuss and design airfoils. The camber line of an airfoil is a line that represents the curvature or profile of the wing surface. It is a curve you get if you were to trace the midpoint between the upper and lower surface of the wing along its span. The camber line is crucial in aerodynamics, influencing how air flows over the wing. A symmetric airfoil has a camber line that is a straight line, no curvature, while a cambered airfoil has a curved camber line. A positive camber line indicates that the upper surface of the wing has more curvature than the lower surface, as in the case of the wings of most aircraft. Meanwhile, a negative camber means the lower surface is more curved, as in the case of the horizontal stabilizer, producing lift downward to balance the aircraft. The shape and degree of camber affects lift, drag, and other aerodynamic characteristics of the wing. In simple terms, the camber line provides a visual representation of the curvature of the wing, and this is used to analyze its shape to optimize the performance of an aircraft's wing. Relative wind is the airflow experienced by not just the wings, but the whole aircraft as it moves through the air. It is defined as the air that flows against the flight path and is a key factor in generating lift. Here are a few examples illustrating relative wind and flight path. Speaking of angles, let's explore the angle of attack and angle of incidence. These are essential concepts in understanding how the aerofoil interacts with the air. The angle of attack is the angle between the chord line and the relative wind. Meanwhile, the angle of incidence is the angle formed by the wing's chord line and the aircraft's longitudinal axis. Discover more about the longitudinal axis by watching our video on aircraft axis. The link is available in the description below. Having examined the fundamental components contributing to lift production, let's delve into a few essential physics concepts. These principles will enhance our understanding of the theories that elucidate the mechanisms behind lift generation. In nature, high pressure moves towards low pressure due to the pressure gradient. We see this in many things in nature, from something as simple as wrestling to more complex systems like the high and low pressure systems of weather. So remember, high pressure moves towards low pressure. The conservation of mass principle dictates that the mass flow rate remains constant along the aerofoil surface. As the aircraft moves forward, the air adjusts its speed to accommodate changes in curvature, resulting in acceleration, to maintain a continuous and controlled flow. Viscosity, the resistance of air to shear, contributes to the formation of the boundary layer and the adherence of air particles to the aerofoil surface. The journey begins at the leading edge, where the aerofoil's curvature guides the air particles. The boundary layer, influenced by viscosity, ensures a smooth and attached airflow along the surface, creating a cohesive stream of air particles. This property helps delay flow separation, ensuring that air remains attached for optimal lift generation. In addition, the Coanda effect refers to the tendency of a fluid, such as air or water, to adhere to a curved surface rather than follow a straight path. When a fluid stream encounters a curved surface, it tends to stay attached to that surface, even if the surface curves away from the original flow direction. Having examined a few fundamental physics concepts essential for grasping the theories behind lift generation, let's now explore two widely accepted explanations for lift production: Newton's third law and Bernoulli's principle. Understanding the cause of lift can be complex and can be explained in several different ways. Newton's third law and Bernoulli's principle are two common explanations for this phenomenon. Simply put, the wing pushes air downward, leading to an upward reaction force known as lift. This is Newton's third law at work. At the same time, the shape of the wing causes air to move faster over the top surface, decreasing pressure and contributing to lift. This is Bernoulli's principle in play. Now let's delve into these a bit more, starting with Newton's third law. Let's start by refreshing our memory on Newton's third law. Simply put, the law states that for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Consider a balloon filled with air. When you release the air, it rushes out, pushing the balloon in the opposite direction. This is due to Newton's third law, stating that for every action, the airflow rushing out, there is an equal and opposite reaction, the balloon moving in the opposite direction to the airflow. The force of the escaping air propels the balloon forward, illustrating the law's practical application in a straightforward manner. Now, how does Newton's third law come into play in generating lift by the wings? For this law to work, the wings are slightly tilted upward with a positive angle of incidence. As the aircraft moves through the air, the wings deflect air downward, this is the action. And the equal and opposite reaction to this is the wings get pushed upward. This upward force is what we commonly refer to as lift. In reality, even a flat plate at an angle will generate lift. This is just like tilting your hand slightly upward when you put it against the wind while driving and your hand starts lifting up. In case of the aerofoil shape, they are optimized for better lift to drag ratio than a flat plate or any other similar shape. If we consider a broader perspective of airflow behavior, the aerofoil influences the air beyond its immediate surroundings. Upstream of the aerofoil, the airflow is directed upwards, known as upwash. And downstream, as it leaves the trailing edge, the flow is redirected downwards, referred to as downwash. This involves a substantial volume of displaced air. The aerofoil plays a crucial role in creating a force on the airflow, resulting in the downwash as the action, and the equal and opposite reaction generating lift. Let's understand now how Bernoulli's principle plays a pivotal role in the production of lift. Named after the Swiss mathematician and physicist Daniel Bernoulli, this principle states that as the speed of a fluid, like air, increases, its pressure decreases and vice versa. Just to clarify, a fluid is a substance that flows and takes the shape of its container, encompassing both liquids and gases. The Bernoulli's tube experiment is a classic demonstration of Bernoulli's principle, showcasing the relationship between fluid flow, velocity, and pressure. In this setup, a horizontal tube narrows at one point, causing the fluid, usually air or water, to accelerate as it passes through this constriction. As the fluid velocity increases, according to Bernoulli's principle, its pressure decreases. The experiment typically involves a manometer connected to the tube to measure the pressure difference at different points. When the fluid speeds up in the narrower section, the manometer shows a decrease in pressure. This illustrates the inverse relationship between fluid velocity and pressure, described by Bernoulli's principle. The experiment is a tangible way to observe how changes in fluid flow impact pressure, providing insights into the fundamental principles of fluid dynamics. See what this shape looks like? As air flows over an aircraft's wing, it encounters varying speeds along the wing's upper surface and lower surface due to the aerofoil shape. Due to conservation of mass, air starts accelerating over the upper surface of the wing due to its curvature. According to Bernoulli's principle, where the air speed is faster, lower pressure is created. Meanwhile, on the lower surface, where the airflow is slower relative to the upper surface, the pressure is higher. We know higher pressure moves towards lower pressure. This movement, which is upward, results in an upward force, the lift. Another way to understand this pressure difference is by considering the rarefaction of air particles as they stretch over the upper surface compared to the lower surface. In other words, there are more particles below, tightly packed, resulting in higher pressure, and fewer particles above, stretched out, leading to lower pressure. This creates a pressure differential, ultimately giving rise to lift. Newton's laws of motion are statements concerning the conservation of momentum, while Bernoulli's equation is derived by considering conservation of energy. And both of these equations are satisfied in the generation of lift. Both shed light to lift production from a different perspective. And there you go, the fascinating tale of lift, the magical force that transforms dreams of flight into a reality. If you found this journey through the skies enjoyable, please show your support by giving us a thumbs up. Feel free to share your thoughts or topic suggestions in the comments below. And don't forget to share this video with your friends. Until next time, keep looking up.